So poetry is a soul talk. It's an emotional, a laden place where you really get deep into your soul. It's the only place where I think I can speak from a depth of myself that you can't really do with other writing. My name is Luis Javier Rodriguez. I am a short story writer. I've written a novel. I've got all this poetry. I got two children's books. And of course, I got memoirs and I got a nonfiction book. The keystone of my writing is my memoirs, both Always Running and It Calls You Back, because these are stories of people struggling. There are odysseys to find home against great odds. I mean, I don't mean home just a place to go to, home inside of yourself. Big America, improperly sized, give me your true value realized. Writing is really my way impacting the world. Writing is power. Writing, it's a way to shape the world. I was born in El Paso, Texas, but you know, we really were anchor babies. My parents wanted to come to the United States. They were living in Ciudad Juarez. My mom wanted to make sure we were born in the U.S. And then when I was 2 years old, even though we lived in Ciudad Juarez, we moved to Los Angeles. We ended up in Watts. There were still restrictive covenants, you know. Blacks were particularly impacted, but Mexicans were too. We weren't able to live just anywhere. It was always instability, moved from one place to the other. My dad kept losing jobs. We kept getting evicted. And then at eight, I moved to the San Gabriel Valley in our little barrio. We called it Las Lomas. We were living in a dirt road, poor little shack, you know. Then the road hit a cornfield where we used to play, and the white landowner used to shoot us with a shotgun. But because of all these issues, poverty, discrimination, a very strong, powerful gang grew out of that neighborhood. My brother used to beat the heck out of me, abuse me, and I couldn't do anything about it. And there was no place to go. And I was a very sensitive kid. And then because of that, I was being bullied. At 9 years old, I got beat up really badly. They jumped me and they cracked my jaw. Girls made fun of me, they called me monkey. I had no friends. And I think I joined the gang at 11 years old because it was the only place where that embraced who I was. I started doing huffing right away. I got addicted to that. I started doing heroin, you know, from snorting to shooting it, you know, in your muscles. I've shot people. I got arrested for attempted murder when I was 17. I was on murder's row when I was 16. I saw so many people die. By the time I was 18, 25 of my friends had died. The only thing that saved me is that sensitive kid. I would love to go to libraries. I still read books. That was my favorite spot. Even when I was homeless downtown LA, I would end up in that library. And the library opened up my imagination, my mind. The power of language and words and books was a very instrumental thing that helped me think I could go somewhere else. The Chicano moratorium was probably the biggest single most important thing that happened to me. I saw the people, I saw the signs, I saw the voices, I saw the unity. My attitude though was completely different. I was a gang member. I didn't go to get politicized and I went to just party. They arrested me like about five of us gang members, cholos, were kept. And then they put us in murder's row. They were gonna try to get us for the murders of all these people, including Ruben Salazar. They couldn't pin it on the five cholos. So they let us all go. That's how I gravitated towards the Chicano activists. They helped me get out of heroin. They helped me get out of the gang life. I wrote in jail. I wrote my first little poems. I didn't know they were poems. Even in jail, that's what I wanted to do, read and or write. And that became my life. I've been working with gangs, gang prevention, gang intervention for over 40 years. I spent 15 years in Chicago and working with gang kids there. I worked with the Bloods and Crips when they were trying to do trucing here. I don't forget those that others forget. When people look at criminals and tattooed face gangsters, I see possible human beings that could do some good. I talk to them, I find the best in them because they all seem to have it. We also have teatruches that serves 15,000 to 18,000 people a year with music, theater, dance, writing, you know, all kinds of arts. We invested in it for the first 5 years. Me and my wife kept the place going for no pay. That's my giving, and that's my cause. It's related to the cause that I've given myself. I love LA. I can't forget its smells. I love to make love in LA. It's a great city, a city without a handle. The world's most mixed metropolis of intolerance and divisions. How I love it, how I hate it. Zoot suit riots, can't stay away. City of hunger, city of angers. Ruben Salazar, Rodney King, I like to kick its face in. Bone City, dried blood on walls, wildfires, taunting dove whales, car fumes and oil derricks, water thievery, with every industry possible, and still a one industry town, lined by those majestic palm trees, and like its people, with solid roots, supple trunks, resilient. I do use words, language, poetry, any way that I can to convince people that there's a better world possible, and we can help make that world.